In the headlines, two area men are behind bars after police find them with several stolen guns. And police need your help in locating a wanted robbery suspect. That's in today's crime report. And she's making an impact on the Black legacy of Rocky Mount. We highlight yet another in our Leaders of Today series during this Black History Month. These stories and more coming up on NewsBreak starting now.
From WHIG-TV, this is NewsBreak 31. Now, here's Marie Torres.
Hello, and thanks for watching WHIG-TV NewsBreak, your voice in the community. I'm Marie Torres. In our crime report, two area men are behind bars after police find them with several stolen guns. According to Rocky Mount Police, Monday afternoon they responded to a call on the 1700 block of Pender Street, and where the two suspects, 21-year-old Jarrell Elijah Vick and 22-year-old Marcus DeKeith Hines, were allegedly firing shots. Police say they tracked the suspects into a wooded area where they found both Vick and Hines in possession of eight guns, seven of which were verified as stolen from American Jewelry and Pawn in late December. Each received a $30,000 secured bond and were taken to Edgecombe County Jail. Police need your help in locating a wanted robbery suspect. Rocky Mount PD says 22-year-old Delacio Kelly Grimes has been identified as a suspect in a January residential breaking and entering case that occurred at 808 Belvedere Street. He is wanted for felony breaking and entering, felony larceny, and obtaining property by false pretenses. If you know his whereabouts, you're asked to contact Crime Stoppers at 252-977-1111. And charges have yet to be filed after a horrendous accident early this week. Monday around 10 p.m., 52-year-old Middlesex man John William Perry reportedly stepped out near oncoming traffic and was first struck by a car merging on U.S. Highway 64 near NC 58. The driver was going 55 in a 70-mile-per-hour zone. According to North Carolina Highway Patrol, the impact sent Perry further into the road, where he was hit by an additional four more cars and then a tractor-trailer truck. Authorities say Perry was pronounced dead approximately 150 feet from where he was initially hit. Drivers first thought they had hit a deer and pulled over. The driver of the tractor trailer, however, did not. Last we've learned, authorities were still trying to track down that driver. The accident left eastbound lanes of US 64 closed for several hours overnight. After the break, we uncover an area gem and highlight her in our local Leaders of Today. But first, stay tuned to today's Black History Facts.
Moment is brought to you by the Solomon Law Firm, specializing in real estate law and criminal defense. Call William Solomon Jr. Attorney at Law for an appointment at 252-442-0348. The Solomon office located at 121 South Grace Street, Rocky Mount.
Here are your Black History Facts. James West's research in sound technology led to the development of foil electric transducers used in 90% of all microphones built today and in most new telephones being manufactured. West holds 47 U.S. and more than 200 foreign patents on microphones and techniques for making polymer foil electrodes. He was inducted into the National Inventors Hall of Fame in 1999. After a long career as an actress and singer, Pearl Bailey earned a bachelor's in theology from Georgetown University in 1985.
You waited patiently. Now it's time. Clearance time at Davenport Honda in Rocky Mount. Hundreds of brand new Hondas all tagged with the year's lowest prices, with savings up to $6,000 and a lifetime warranty on every vehicle. But hurry, because at Davenport Honda, these deals are the one thing that won't last forever. Davenport Honda in Rocky Mount, your dealership for life.
Mm-hmm. We're your news team bringing it home to you with meteorologist Fred Holdsworth, anchor Marie Torres, sports reporter Edward Green, and Matt Habit, our studio guy. WHIG-TV NewsBreak, your voice in the community.
The Country Inn & Suites is your home away from home with a staff that always treats you as family. If you or your church or company has visitors, give them a great Rocky Mount welcome with a special discount on their overnight or extended stay. Not only is the Country Inn & Suites a comfortable place, we'll spoil them with fresh cookies and complimentary breakfast. We're filled with luxuries like an indoor pool, fitness center, and a guest laundry. The business center includes a boardroom, connection to high-speed internet, and catering for meetings is always available. Call me, Donna Vachavis, at 252-442-0500 for a tour and or to set up your corporate rate. You're always welcome as family in the country, Country Inn & Suites, Rocky Mount.
Welcome back to WHIG-TV NewsBreak. I'm Marie Torres. Throughout the month of February, we're highlighting those black leaders who've made an impact on the lives of our community. Continuing our Black History Month series, here's WHIG-TV's Leader of Today.
I've got some history.
And that's why we came to Rosa Battle, called by some Baby Ruth, to understand the deep roots of the black legacy in Rocky Mount. Battle, one of the three survivors in her neighborhood, is in her 80s, but is able to recollect even the slightest detail of the events she played a part in her life, even meeting Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
Martin Luther King Jr. and Reverend Dudley at Mount Zion First Baptist Church were close friends, and he invited him here, and he spoke out there, "I have a dream," at the Booker T. Washington High School, and before going on to Washington, D.C. to do it.
Battle jokingly says though seeing Dr. King was a great moment in her life, the time spoke to the level of undevelopment in Rocky Mount.
Sherman Brown, Helen Brown's husband, he catered it. And back then, with this great man being here, we had box lunches and tea in a paper cup. And we had on evening gowns. I was so embarrassed.
Despite that, Battle says meeting Dr. King was unforgettable.
Oh, it was great. It was great. I've been down there several times. Reverend Dudley carried to his funeral. He carried three busloads down there.
And that's in Georgia.
That's Atlanta, Georgia. When Dr. Martin Luther King expired, it just broke my heart because it was so many people here that walked with him when he was coming through. But the main thing was him coming here to speak and did that dream. I had a dream. Here before taking that long walk to the Lincoln Memorial. And we were just amazed at it. And I still have the collection of it over there, and I will have it until I depart, because he's the greatest speaker I ever heard.
She also told us about one of the historically black areas in Rocky Mount, the Douglas Block, and how she has seen it change over the years.
So a lot of black-owned businesses.
They own from Atlantic Avenue to Main Street.
Right.
They owned it all. All of those buildings until the city started fixing it up. Mm-hmm. After the parents died, everything went down.
And even more, this great woman felt especially touched by the death of President John F. Kennedy, so she did something about it.
When I was in Germany, I was in my dining room in Nyon, Germany, and it came across that he had been shot. And then a little while later, they said he had expired. I went in the dining room again and got me a piece of paper and my pen, and I wrote to Jackie. And I have the letter today. And when I went to the White House with the BTW Senior Citizens, my letter was up in that Kennedy's Museum, and I was one proud black woman. And when I wrote her, I always keep me a copy of what I send off, and she answered it. I know the secretaries who do all that answer, and I still have that collection today, and I'm proud of that too, because he was, to me, other than Barack Obama, the greatest president. And both of them were dynamic speakers, and they cared and shared with other people. They weren't about themselves.
Battle read to us her photocopied letter that she has kept for years.
Dear Mrs. Kennedy, your husband's death was a great shock to the world. And in Germany, where I am stationed with my husband, they gave great honor to him. The 21-gun salute and the 50-gun salute. That was a great token taken away from you in Dallas, Texas, when your husband's life was snuffed out. It was a big burden, but you picked up your cross and never said a mumbling word and carried it with love and courage in your heart.
As a leader who has received dozens of awards for her service to the community, Battle tells us what she is most proud of.
When I was helping the people at need, the Salvation Army, and helping those unlearned people to get their utilities and get their disabilities, taking them to the doctor, never charged anybody anything, and it was just great to go and carry them. And then when the flood was, I worked out there to OIC the whole time, distributing food stamps, food, clothes, and didn't accept one living dime. And it was just a joy to see them. I take cases of water, cases of food, cases of clothes and shoes. The people were just so nice.
She tells us her hope for tomorrow.
I hope that they will get these boards off of these houses and put those homeless people in those houses and try to give them some jobs and let them have clothing like we have, food, and just care about them. Send them to the doctor. We really need that health care. We need it. You got to go to see the predicament these people are in.
And her final thoughts?
I don't want none of this read when I expire. They already have thanked me. The people thank you, and you don't have to worry about somebody sending up their car's address to the Battle of Family, and you standing up there reading them to people that don't know anything about it. I don't want anything read.
Rosa B. Battle, WHIG-TV's Leader of Today. Again, we'll be highlighting other leaders in our community this month. After the break, it's sports and weather, but first, here are more facts on African Americans who've helped mold our great nation.
Breaking track star was born the 20th of 22 children and stricken with polio as a child. She not only overcame polio, but break world records in three Olympic track events and was the first American woman to win three gold medals at the Olympics. 2 years after she played the role of Dorothy Dandridge, the first African-American woman to earn an Academy Award nomination for Best Actress, performer Halle Berry actually became the first African-American woman to win the Oscar for Best Actress.
This Black History Moment is brought to you by the Solomon Law Firm, specializing in real estate law and criminal defense. Call William Solomon Jr. Attorney at Law for an appointment at 252-442-0348. The Solomon office located at 121 South Grace Street, Rocky Mount.
You've waited patiently. Now it's time. Clearance time at Davenport Honda in Rocky Mount. Hundreds of brand new Hondas all tagged with the year's lowest prices, with savings up to $6,000 and a lifetime warranty on every vehicle. But hurry, because at Davenport Honda, these deals are the one thing that won't last forever. Davenport Honda in Rocky Mount, your dealership for life.
Country Inn & Suites is your home away from home with a staff that always treats you as family. If you or your church or company has visitors, give them a great Rocky Mount welcome with a special discount on their overnight or extended stay. Not only is the Country Inn & Suites a comfortable place, we'll spoil them with fresh cookies and complimentary breakfast. We are filled with luxuries like an indoor pool, fitness center, and a guest laundry. The business center includes a boardroom, connection to high-speed internet, and catering for meetings is always available. Call me, Donna Chavis, at 252-442-0500 for a tour and or to set up your corporate rate. You're always welcome as family in the country, Country Inn and Suites, Rocking Out.
Thanks for staying with us. Now for a look at warm weather ahead, here's WHIG-TV meteorologist Fred Holdsworth. Fred?
We'll take a look at the weather now, and we'll see that we're into a gradual warm-up time, and this is a first taste of spring, I guess we could call it, and that doesn't mean it's going to stay this way, because spring is generally a time of up and down temperatures, a temperature roller coaster, and we'll experience some high temperatures and then some low ones for high temperatures. And the high temperature tomorrow should be in the mid-70s. And then when we go into Saturday, again, we go into the mid-60s for Saturday and Sunday as a cold front comes through. But it's a dry one. There won't be any precipitation with it. And although we do need some, we won't be getting any with this cold front. Let's take a look at our forecast map and see what we have going on today. First of all, we could see some rain showers along the coast from, let's say, around West Palm Beach, Florida, northward to the North Carolina-South Carolina border as some moisture is pushed in off the Atlantic. Then as we go farther to the west, North Central Texas and Northeast Texas, this area right through here into Oklahoma and Arkansas, could see rain later on today. A warm front is kicking off some rain showers and rain up over the Great Lakes all the way down into Iowa. And then as we go farther to the west, a cold front, it's actually two cold fronts, will bring a widespread area of snow all the way from Hudson's Bay down into northern Arizona, and then even farther west, almost to the Pacific coast. Some heavy snow is possible in the Central Valley of California today. They've had a pretty good snow season this year, and this is, of course, in connection with their rainy season. rain and even some thunderstorms will be possible all the way down to the Los Angeles area. And then back up along the coast, we could see some snow possible in southern British Columbia with rain along the Oregon and Washington coast. So quite a bit of precipitation today, but most of it will be to the west of the Mississippi River, with the exception of this area right over the Great Lakes. Well, let's take a look now at our forecast and see what we can expect for the next few days going through the weekend, which, by the way, is a holiday weekend, the President's Day weekend. For today, fog during the morning. It will be burning off by mid-morning. Mostly sunny with a high of 70. Southwest wind at 10 to 20 miles per hour. For tonight, fog will be developing once again with a mostly cloudy sky, a low of 50 and a south wind at 8. Friday, fog during the morning, then becoming sunny with a high of 75. Wind southwest 10 to 15 miles per hour. Friday night, partly cloudy with a low of 45 and a west wind at 7. Saturday, sunny, a little bit cooler on Saturday with a high of 68. Northwest wind 10, gusting around 25 miles per hour. Saturday night, partly cloudy with a low of 35. For Sunday, partly cloudy with a high of 65. Sunday night, mostly cloudy with a low of 49 degrees. Monday, partly cloudy with a high of 65 and a low of 42 Monday night. 62 was yesterday's high. Our high this morning was 34. And that's a look at your Rocky Mount weather right up to the minute. Now back to you.
Thanks, Fred. And here with us now is WHIG-TV sports reporter Edward Green. What's going on in sports this week, Edward?
Well, we have the Big East Conference tournament going on. We got the finals tomorrow, but I want to take a closer look at one team who unfortunately won't be playing in the finals. Mm-hmm. The Big East Basketball Conference is given 4 spots in the 64-team state championship bracket. Now, these spots are given to the 4 top teams in the conference standings, but the bottom 2 teams can still play their way into the dance by winning the conference tournament. That was the scenario Southern Nash coach Robbie Kennedy found himself in this week. And I spoke to Coach Kennedy after his run came up just a bit short.
All right, we are here with Coach Kennedy in his office at Southern Nash. And Coach Kennedy, sorry your season has ended a little sooner, I know, than you wanted to, but just talk about your final Big East tournament game against Northern Nash.
We played really well. It's kind of a microcosm of our whole season. Played really well early. Lost our composure a little bit. Josh Sessoms got in foul trouble. We were tied at halftime. Third quarter, we scored 5 points, and then we scored 22 in the fourth. We've been inconsistent all season as far as scoring, and that really hurt us last night. We went like 4 or 5 minutes and just couldn't put the ball in the basket.
Now, there is something you were talking to me about off camera, is that you told your guys about how your season went overall, the difference between finishing 3-7 in fifth place and 5-5 maybe.
We lost to Central and Northern back-to-back Tuesdays by 3. Both games had a chance to win in the last minute. And that's why I told them, Rocky Mount was 7-3, Central was 6-4, Northern was 5-5, we were 3-7. 2 wins. We lost 7 games by 6 points or less, and all 7 we had a chance in the last 2 minutes to win. We talked about, as a team, our role players being more consistent. When you get a chance to make a shot, making that shot. Last night we wanted to make 20 and 22 beat us. They both hit jump shots, and our role players didn't make shots.
What do you tell your team going into this kind of conference tournament situation where you have to win to keep your season alive and make the state playoffs?
Well, except for Rocky Mount Hunt, we've played everybody close, and we've had a chance to win a lot of games. And we told them, it's a 1-game season. If we could beat Northern, get another chance at Hunt. And we came out last night perfect, jumped on them early, had an 8-point lead, got away from them for a little bit. We were down 7, had a chance to possibly cut it to 5, and the Freeman kid hits a 3. But I thought our effort was awesome, and the kids played their tails off. We don't have a problem in all years, just a question of being able to score consistently.
Well, like you say, you're not that far off from maybe next year competing for a playoff spot. What do you think's one or two things that need to change to do that?
We got 13 players, only have 2 seniors. The whole starting lineup's back. And that's what we just talked as a team at our end of season meeting. And one of the things we talked about was we know we're going to get 15 points from Josh. We know we're going to get 10 or 15 from Tony and Marcus. So that's 40. We need our role players to, you know, if they can just average 3 or 4 points apiece. And we always talked about, you know, when we practice, you know, we get better from March to September. You know, you can't get a lot better during the season. As a team, you can. But, you know, as a player, you need to work during the off season. And we talked about, you know, working on off season, doing stuff, game speed, you know, going to team camp, trying to play some AAU ball together, just playing more basketball. You know, and that's hard because we have a lot of kids that play football, basketball, baseball. And I've got 4 that play baseball, football, and basketball. And I told them, you know, I know you got to work on all 3, but for you to be, you know, that's the life, that's what you've chosen to do. So we need you in the gym as much as possible.
Coach Kennedy, sorry your season is over, but better luck next season. Appreciate getting them back on track.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Northern Nash continued its hot streak by upending regular season champion last night, Wilson Hunt, 68-65. And they will play Rocky Mount on Friday after the Griffons beat Nash Central last night, 76-62. Now, Marie, all 4 of these teams have locked up a spot in the state playoffs, so they're all set to go. But it's always important to have a good amount of momentum going into the tournament, obviously. And the finals tomorrow night will be at Rocky Mount, the same place Northern Nash beat Rocky Mount in the championship game of the Christmas tournament. So a little payback might be in mind all for Rocky
right.
Mount.
All right. Well, we still wish them both the best of luck. So thank you again,
thanks,
Edward.
Marie.
Coming up next week, home shopping giant QVC is hoping to add 500 more jobs to the area, and a local school is handed a big check to further their future leaders. Tune in Monday for our live news at noon to watch our coverage. We want to give you a quick announcement. The town of Princeville will be celebrating their 126th birthday anniversary, and that's going to take place Friday, February 18th at the Princeville Town Hall at 2 p.m. at 201 Main Street in Princeville, North Carolina. Thanks for tuning in to NewsBreak today. Join us next week as we continue to bring you news that's impacting our community. For WHIG-TV, I'm Marie Torres. We'll see you next time.